Hi, everybody. My name is Marissa, and I have a bachelor's degree in mathematics with a minor in statistics. In today's lesson, I will describe statistical correlation as well as how to utilize correlation coefficients to analyze the relationship between variables. When you hear the word correlation, what do you think of? You may think of variables such as height and weight or number of absences and grades. Correlation measures both the strength and the direction of a linear relationship. Linear relationships describe two variables that, when plotted, form a line. The strength of a linear relationship measures how close data points are to a straight line when plotted, and the direction measures if the variables are positively correlated or negatively correlated. For example, height and weight are positively correlated because as height increases, so does weight. However, a relationship such as number of absences and grades would be negatively correlated because the more classes you miss, the lower your grades will be. Now that we understand how linear relationships are measured, we can now discuss the statistic used to quantify this relationship, the correlation coefficient. The correlation coefficient, denoted by R, can tell us both the strength and direction of a linear relationship. The value of R is always between -1 and +1. The magnitude of a correlation coefficient describes how close the points are to a straight line when we plot the relationship on a graph. The sign of a correlation coefficient, either negative or positive, tells us if variables are negatively or positively correlated. The closer the value of R is to +1, the stronger the positive relationship. The closer the value of R is to -1, the stronger the negative relationship. If a correlation coefficient is 0, it means that two variables are unrelated and form a horizontal line when plotted on a chart. The formula for the correlation coefficient, R, is 1 over n minus 1 times the sum of each value of x minus the mean of x divided by the standard deviation of x times each value of y minus the mean of y divided by the standard deviation of y. For example, let's say that we have the values 95, 83, 72, 64, and 57 for x, and the values 1, 3, 4, 6, and 7 for y. Please note that we must have the same number of x and y values in order to compute the correlation coefficient. We begin our calculation by computing the value of the mean for x and y. Recall that the mean is computed by summing our values and then dividing by n, the number of values. Using this information, we compute the mean of x to be 74.2 and the mean of y to be 4.2. We now must compute the standard deviation of x and y. We do this by subtracting each value of x from the mean and squaring that value, and then summing the results. We then divide by n minus 1 and take the square root of that result. We do the same process for y. We now must multiply each value of x minus the mean of x divided by the standard deviation of x by each value of y minus the mean of y divided by the standard deviation of y. We then multiply by 1 over 5 minus 1. This gives us a value of 1 over 4 times -3.96. This results in a correlation coefficient of -0.99. The squared value of the correlation coefficient, denoted by R squared, is used to measure the strength of a linear relationship, but not the direction. R squared can be written in both capital and lowercase letters. R squared is always between 0 and 1. However, it can sometimes be expressed as a percentage between 0% and 100%. R squared is also used to describe the amount of variation in the dependent variable that the independent variable is responsible for. In other words, if height is our independent variable and weight is our dependent variable, an R squared value of 0.56 would indicate that 56% of the variation in one's weight can be explained by their height. The value of R squared can be calculated by simply squaring the value of R. Let's test what we've learned today about statistical correlation by doing two quick exercises. Question 1. What value of R, the correlation coefficient, would be the most reasonable to describe the relationship between vision and age? Explain your reasoning. Answer choice A, 0. Answer choice B, -0.67. Answer choice C, 0.67. Answer B will be the correct choice for question 1. We know that answer choice A is incorrect because we know that when people age, their vision tends to worsen, and an R value of 0 would indicate that there is no relationship between age and vision. Answer choice C is incorrect because an R value of 0.67 would indicate a positive relationship between age and vision. Question 2. Calculate the value of R and R squared for the following data set, X, 58, 60, 63, 65, 67, Y, 93, 102, 117, 124, 132. We begin question 2 by computing the mean and standard deviation of X and Y. Using a formula for mean, we obtain 62.6 as our mean for x and 113.6 as our mean for y. Using a formula for standard deviation, we obtain a standard deviation of 3.65 for x and 15.95 for y. Using these values, we must multiply the value of 1 over 5 minus 1 by each value of x minus x bar divided by the standard deviation of x times each value of y minus y bar divided by the standard deviation of y. This gives us an r value of 0.998. By squaring r, we get an r squared value of 0.996. Great job, everyone. Today we learned about what it means for variables to be statistically correlated. We also learned how to utilize correlation coefficients to analyze the relationship between variables. Thanks for watching, and please check out other videos about statistics lessons and applications here on Chegg. Have a fantastic day, and I'll see you next time.